Hi, my name is David, and in today's video, I'm going to give you a quick explanation on different paper types, and I'm going to show you how you can set up your printer to accept a custom paper type. As an example, I'm going to do that for the Canon LBP-623cdw, which is the printer that we use in our latest white toner printer, Little Ghost. You will be able to do that with other printers as well. Depends on the printer, the settings might vary, but for this printer, I will show you the process and walk you through it. But first, what is a custom paper type? There are standard paper types, such as, for example, A4 or 8.5 by 11 for those who are on the other side of the big ocean, or, for example, A5, which is used in cards, which is basically just half of an A4 sheet. These are standard paper types. The printer knows these paper types and comes with pre-installed settings for these paper types. So it knows the sizes and the length, and you can just choose these paper types from your printer driver. But maybe you want to print on a media which is not of standard measurements like DIN or ISO standard. Like these ones here, you can see it's a multitude of different media. For example, these are envelopes which do not have a standard size. This is also like a square envelope, not a standard size. We've got a little bigger envelope, also not a standard size. We've got a bigger card, which is, if you look at our standard, it's not half A4, it's actually wider, but it's also not like this, so it's a different size as well. And we even got a card, it's a foldable card, that is overlength, that is a little bit longer than A4. So how to deal with all these different papers? The Canon printer driver allows us to register a custom paper type. You can also save multiple custom paper types where you can choose from papers as long as up to 35.5 centimeters, 35.5 centimeters or 355 millimeters. So you will be able to use this printer to actually print on media that is a little longer than A4. And you can also print cards as small as just 10 centimeters in width. So I will just quickly head over to the screen and show you the settings that you have to make in your printer driver to get this going. Okay, I've got the list of all my printers here. It might look different depending on the operating system that you are using. And I go to print standards. This might be a print settings in your setup or something like that. But basically you will enter into this, which is the driver screen that you are familiar with. So you go to page settings, and then down here at the left-hand bottom, you have user-defined paper. You just open that, and it gives you a list of all the papers. Gives you just a list of all the standard papers. Here we've got our A5, just talked about it. We've got A4, just talked about it. And we've got some different envelopes. So I have this one envelope here, and I'm going to quickly take a ruler to measure out this envelope. So I'll take a ruler and see, okay, this is about 16 centimeters by 11.5 centimeters, okay? So I'm just going to type in a name for this, and I call this small underline envelope underline 16 by 11. Should be fine, should be really okay with that. And then I'm going to insert the length and the width of this thing. So I'm going to put 11 here. It also gives you the maximum and minimum dimensions on the side here. And I'm going to put in 16 here. And I say register. And now you can see that here on the list on the left hand side, we've got that small envelope underlined 1617, and you see the measures here. And now you've got that saved. You just go to OK. And now the printer driver offers this as an option when you choose the page format for printing. You can say small envelope 16 by 11. So let's just quickly register another one. User defined format. I'm going to measure out this long one here. This long card, which is actually oversized. So that is 155, so 15.5. And that's exactly, or it's even longer than my ruler. It's exactly 31. So we type that in. I call that card underline 155 by 310. And I insert these measures here, 155 by 310. And I say register, and voila, another paper format registered. So is there anything else to do? Yes, there is. I'll quickly save that. Confirm, okay. And now I'm going to go over to the printer and have these registered within the printer as well. Once on the printer, we're waking up the printer. Once the printer is waked up, I'm going to navigate down to paper settings. Once the printer is waked up, I navigate using the arrow keys down to paper settings. Just say okay. And I navigate to register custom paper. Just say okay. It offers you to register up to 3 custom papers. You see that I've got already 2 registered. I just choose the 3rd one now. And it actually gives you a little image on which side is which. So the first paper I want to register is my 110 by 160, which was the envelope. And I just say apply. And then I can also choose a paper type. If I say free, it will select the paper type that you select by printing. But as I know this is an envelope, I will already say, okay, you're an envelope, there you go. And I will also register or re-register a second paper type. I just choose this one here and I go to edit. And I just confirm the settings all the way through and say apply. And now it's cardstock. So this card is actually pretty heavy. So I think it's even heavier than 163 GSM. So I'm looking if we have something even more stronger here. We've got heavy 1, heavy 2, we've got labels. Okay, so we choose the most heavy paper type that we can choose. So that one, okay, and save that one as well. Now you can just use the home button to return to the home screen, or you can navigate back to the menu anytime by going to paper settings, register new paper type. If you want to get rid of one of the paper types, you just select it and then you select delete. It asks you to confirm that. You always use the arrow buttons to navigate, confirm, and then it's not registered, and you can use that for any other paper type. As you can see, you have multiple steps to take to get a custom paper type registered. But the good thing is, once you've done that, you will not have to mess around with settings. You will not have misalignment when you print on these, you know, really special media. It's really cool that you can use this printer to print stationery that kind of stands out from the standards. And it's really nice to also use non-standard paper sizes. So we hope you find this helpful to, you know, just know how to walk along the settings and make your custom paper settings. Save them as presets and use them multiple times. And if you find this video helpful, we'd love to see a thumbs up on this video. If you've got questions on this or ideas for future videos, please put those down in the comments. Make sure to follow the channel, turn on the bell so that you get notified on new upcoming videos. And I say thanks for watching and see you next time.